Short and sweet, she's a politician, not only sonically manages to sit right between the Badmotorfinger and Superunknown eras, but also give a nod to old-school Soundgarden with its hardcore roots. Why do I say that? The chorus and bridge have this creeping, heavily layered guitar work, and the verse is very chaotic and picks up the pace. And that's a part that you could, if you wanted to, count as 2-4. But you can count the entirety of a song in 4-4, with a verse just doubled in speed. There are two guitars playing through the entirety of it, the entirety being under 2 minutes. And they are playing the same chords and riffs, up until the final note of each bar, where the player is slightly different ornament. These guitars then do split into two different parts for the bridge segment, where you could think of one of them as the rhythm and the other one as the lead, with a third guitar joining for the solo. It's obvious that the song was recorded around the time of Badmotorfinger, though I cannot say whether it is actually an album outtake or stems from a session before or after that, and it also wasn't part of the Stuart Hallerman recordings. Its first release was in 1992, when the band decided to, pretty quickly after its initial release, reissue Badmotorfinger, including an EP, which has this cool palindrome title, Satanoscillatemymetallicsonatas, so that said the same forwards as it is backwards. And according to my sources, the only reason this even got released was to hype up Soundgarden's appearance on the Lollapalooza festival that year. This EP did not actually see a standalone release until 2016. And you'd think, hey, that was probably for Badmotorfinger's 25th anniversary, right? No, it was for Record Store Day. However, this song, She's a Politician, then finally was released on its reissue. So was its demo, which doesn't structurally differ from the studio version. Before that, it was released on the 2014 compilation Echo of Mud, Scattered Tracks Across the Path, and on the 1996 Burden in My Hand single as a B-side. The tuning is standard. We're in E, A, D, G, B, E. The song is opened by a drum fill, and a second later the other instruments join with the vocals. We're in the intro, which is also going to serve as the chorus. We begin by playing power chords, starting on a B5, for which we strum together the second fret on the A and the 4 frets on the D and G strings, followed by an F5, removing this down one string and one fret at a time. So we play the first fret on the low E and the third frets on the A and D strings, then a D5, for which we strum together the open D, the second fret on the G, and the third fret on the B. Then we're going to play an E major chord, and this was tricky to figure out. We're going to be strumming for this the open low E string, the second frets on the A and D, the first fret on the G, and the open B and high E strings. And then strum that again. The reason why I say this was tricky is because in the recording it wasn't really clear whether that's the lower or the higher octave. So I was assuming it would be another power chord. That's the E down here, and the next one is up here. So I was thinking maybe one guitar is playing the lower one and the other the higher one, or one is playing an overlay of the lower octave. But I isolated the guitar tracks, and that's not quite it. It's just that the lower and the higher pitches are shining through irregularly, because this is a major chord that actually combines the low with the high octave. Then we're back to power chords, strumming a G5, for which we play together the 3rd fret on the low E and the 5th frets on the A and D. Next the C5, so we're just moving this up a string, and strum together the 3rd fret on the A and the 5th frets on the D and G. And what I personally do is I'm not even switching between these two chords. My finger is still barring from the G5, and now I'm just moving the ring and pinky fingers down one string at a time. This is a very fast-paced song, and I don't want to make it choppy. It's just a tip from me. Then we're playing a riff, which starts by plucking the open low E string, followed by the 2nd fret, the 1st, the open string, then the open A, 2nd fret E, and from now we're going to be repeating a couple of times. The open string, 2nd fret, open, 2nd, open, 2nd, open, and now the 2nd fret with a quarter bend, which is ever so slightly moved up, open. And now for the final notes is where the two guitars are going to differ. The first one is going to be sliding the 2nd fret of a low E string up the neck. The second guitar is going to be plucking the open A string. And I'd like to make a note on the strumming pattern here. This is a very chaotic song. There's no set strumming pattern, so you have to see how you play it in a way that makes sense to you so you can get to the notes in time. I can demonstrate how I personally wrote it out for myself. I begin on a downstroke, followed by another. Then I play an upstroke, and another. Downstroke, another. Upstroke, downstroke. And then for the riff, you gotta see whether you find you play more fluidly with alternate picking, meaning every downstroke is followed by an upstroke and so on, or with just down picking. Alternate picking would look like this. Down picking would look like this. You could of course also be playing a mix thereof. Now let's play through this bar and its two variations at the end, slowly. That's the first bar of the verse. The two guitars continue. We're starting by playing the D5 chord we've already learned, followed by the F5 we've already learned, Next we're going to be playing the slower voicing E5 that I've briefly mentioned in the last bar. By strumming together the open low E string and the second frets on the A and D. Next an A5, which I'm just moving a string at a time. So now we're strumming together the open A string and the second frets on the D and G. Follow this with another A5. And then a C5 that we've already learned. And I'm using this trick again where I'm already barring the third fret on the low E string without playing it yet. Because the next two chords are going to be the G5 that we've already learned. And now we're moving the riff that we've learned in the first bar up one string to play it rather than on the low E string. On the A, beginning by plucking it open, followed by the second fret, first, open, then the open D, second fret A, open, second, open. And this is where the first guitar is now going to be sliding the second fret of the A up the neck for the final note. And the second guitar is just going to be plucking the second fret of the A. Was still in what I would think of the first chorus or intro. It's really a transitional piece into the next verse. So pluck in the open low E string, followed by the second fret with a quarter bend. Open, second, open, second. Second, then we'll play a double on the open string, which you probably want to do with alternate picking. Whether you begin it on a downstroke and follow with an upstroke, or begin it with an upstroke and follow with a downstroke, this needs to be played fast. Then the first guitar is going to be for the final note, slide the second fret off the E up the neck. The second guitar is going to be playing the second fret on the E with a quarter bend. At 17 seconds, we'll be in the first verse. And this is the nod to punk. We play power chords again. Well, this time different voicings. We're going to be playing a D5 by strumming together the 5th fret on the A and the 7th frets on the D and G string. And for the E5, we're sliding this up 2 frets to the 7th, 9th and 9th frets. I'm going to be repeating this 3 times, but I'm alternating between my strums. This was started on downstroke. The next one I'm getting on an upstroke. The next one on a downstroke. And the next one on an upstroke. And if we combine this to play a little bit faster, you will see that it creates this effect where we are not isolating the chords, we are sliding between them, but rather than having the sound weakened, we can thicken it up. So we're simultaneously sliding and strumming. Now at the end of each bars, the guitars are just sliding different notes. The first one is going to be playing the third fret on the low E string, slide that up to the 10th, and that back down the neck. The second guitar is going to be sliding the 9th fret of the D down the neck. The second bar repeats. And then at the end, the first guitar is going to be sliding the 3rd fret of the low E string up to the 12th and then back down the neck. And the second guitar is going to be sliding the 9th fret of the G down to the 4th and then back up the neck. The 3rd bar repeats. And then like in the 1st bar, the 1st guitar is again going to be sliding the 3rd fret of the low E string up to the 10th and then back down the neck. The 2nd guitar again is going to be sliding the 9th fret of the D down the neck. And then the 4th bar repeats. And there's no ornaments at the end there. This then leads us, at 29 seconds, into the pre-chorus, which uses a variation of the riff that we've already learned. So this is two guitars playing the same thing. We start by repeating, plucking the open low E string, followed by the 2nd fret, the 1st, open, the open A, 2nd fret E, open, 2nd, open, 2nd, open, 2nd. Then we'll play a double on the open string, 2nd fret with a quarter bend, open, and slide the 2nd fret up the neck. At 33 seconds, we're continuing the verse, which repeats. So the chord structure is exactly the same. We're sliding between the D5 and the E5 power chords. The ornaments at the end of the bar
we'll have the first guitar, slide the third fret of the low E string up to the 12th and then back down the neck. The second guitar is going to be playing a muted stroke here, by laying the fingers across the strings and striking the A and D, so that no extra notes ring out. The ornaments in the second bar has the first guitar, sliding the third fret of the low E string up to the 10th and then back down the neck. The second guitar is going to be sliding the 7th fret of the G up and then down the neck. The third bar has the ornament on the first guitar, slide the 3rd fret of the low E string up to the 9th and then back down the neck. The second guitar slides up the 4th fret of the G. And then the 4th bar is just for power chords with no ornaments at the end. At this point, I don't think it bears any repeating to demonstrate the chords of a riff at a slow tempo again, just to show you the singular notes that we are sliding, pulling, or bending. So we're going to continue. At 45 seconds, we'll be in the second pre-chorus, which again is a variation of a riff we've already learned. We begin by repeating, plucking the open A string, followed by the 2nd fret, the 1st, open, and the open D. 2nd fret A, open, 2nd, open, 2nd, open, 2nd. Now play a double on the open string. 2nd, open. And now, rather than just playing the 2nd fret, play the B5 that we've already learned. Let this ring out for a moment before, without even picking the string again, sliding the 2nd fret of the A up to the 11th fret and back down the neck. At 52 seconds for the second chorus, we're going to be repeating the chords and riffs. And now for the final ornament, the first guitar is going to be sliding the 2nd fret of the low E string up the neck. The 2nd guitar, simultaneously, is going to be pulling the 2nd fret of the low E string off to the open string. The chorus continues by repeating. And now for the final ornament, the 1st guitar is going to be sliding the 2nd fret of the A up the neck, while the 2nd guitar is going to be playing the 2nd fret of the A with a quarter band. At 1 minute 6 seconds, we're in the bridge segment, which is also going to be leading us into a guitar solo shortly. This is where the two guitars are splitting up to play different parts. Guitar 1 plays. We begin by palm muting, meaning we have to place our hand across the strings so they don't fully ring out. Compare. This is all played on the low E string. We begin by plucking it open. What about the second fret? Then we're repeating. Open, second. Open, second. Open, second. Then we're playing a double on the open by plucking it twice. And then we'll be pulling the second fret off to the open string. That was the first bar, which we're going to be repeating two times. Then for the fourth bar, we begin by repeating the open string. Second, open, second, open, second. Now we stop palm muting. Lift your hand, play the open string. The second with a quarter bend. Open, the second with a quarter bend, and pull it off to the open string. The fifth bar starts with the open string, second, open, second, open, second, open, second, open, and pull the second fret off to the open string. Repeat this twice more. Simultaneously, the second guitar is going to be playing. Begin by plucking the second fret, then the fourth with a quarter bend, second, fourth quarter bend, second, fourth quarter bend, second, fourth quarter bend, then a double on the second, plucking it twice, fourth with quarter bend, second. That's the first bar, which we'll be repeating once. Third bar starts on the second fret, fourth with a quarter bend, second, fourth quarter bend, second, fourth quarter bend, second, fourth quarter bend, second, fourth quarter bend, second. The fourth bar is going to be a repetition of the first two ones, with a double in there. And then the 5th, 6th, 7th, and 8th bars are going to repetition of the 3rd one without the double. Thank you. 11 to 14 seconds, a third guitar joins for a solo. This fades in during the end of the third bars of the two bridge guitars we've just learned. We begin by playing a ghost note, for which we plug the 14th fret on the G at a lower volume. Let this ring out before resuming at full volume with the 11th and the 14th fret. 12th fret B with a quarter bend. 12th fret without any bend. 10th, 12th fret with a half bend, and hold this finger while then plucking the 12th fret on the high E string. Now plucking the 12th fret on the B again to release this bend and play it with vibrato. So that's a pre-bend, right? We are already bending the string up before we strike it, then we release it. After that, the 10th fret. Then the 11th fret on the G, the 9th, the 11th. I'm keeping my fingers in this position now because I'm moving down to the 11th fret of the D before going back to the 9th fret on the G and the 11th. Then the 10th fret B with a quarter bend and vibrato. Let this ring out for a quick moment before very fast plucking the 10th fret twice, and the 12th fret with a half bend. Keep in this bended position while then also plucking the 13th fret, so that is already bent up for us. Then the 12th fret on the high E string with a whole bend. Then the 12th fret without any bends, but vibrato. This rings out. Then we're going to be playing a muted arpeggiated stroke on the D, G, B, and high E strings. So rather than striking them all at the same time or picking them off individually, we're striking them one after another. Then we'll play the 17th fret on the high E string with a half bend. 12th, 14th, 17th, 14th, 12th, again keeping my fingers in this position, then the 16th fret on the G, 14th fret on the B, pull the 17th fret off to the 14th, pluck the 14th, pluck it once more to slide it up the neck. Now I'm going to be playing with tremolo picking, for which I hammer on the 14th fret of the high E string to the 17th. Then the 14th, hammer the 14th fret onto the 17th again, the 14th again, then pull the 17th fret off to the 14th, on the 17th fret on the B, hammer the 14th fret off the high E string onto the 17th again, and the 14th again. This is really no different to alternate picking, but it's going to happen in rapid succession. Down, up, down, up, so on. Then we're back to regular picking on the 17th fret of the B, 16th, 14th, pull the 17th off to the 14th, 16th fret G, 14th, pull the 16th fret off to the 14th, again keeping my fingers in this position, I'm going to play the 16th fret on the D, followed by the 14th fret on the G, which after a slight pause I bend up a half step and release. Then I play a ghost note on this 14th fret, go back to full volume
on the B,
the 17th fret with a half bend, release, pluck the 17th fret without any bend, 14th, 17th, play the 16th fret on the G with a half bend, hammer the 14th fret of the B onto the 16th fret to pull that back off to the 14th. Play the 16th fret with the whole bend. Play the 16th fret without any bend. Pull the 17th fret off to the 14th with a stop. So stop the note from ringing out. And then pluck the 14th fret once more. At 1 minute 31 seconds will be in the third verse, which is also going to serve as the outro. This again is going to be a variation. Begin the bars by repeating the D5 and E5 chords once more. Then, at the end of the bar, the final ornament is going to be played by the first guitar by sliding the third fret of the low E string up to the 12th and that down the neck. The second guitar is going to be sliding the 9th fret of the D down the neck. The ornament at the end of the second bar has the first guitar sliding the third fret of a low E string up to the 13th fret and that down the neck. The second guitar slides the 7th fret of a G up to the 12th and that down the neck. The third bar has the first guitar sliding the third fret of a low E string up to the 10th and that down the neck. The second guitar slides the 9th fret of a G down the neck. The fourth and final bar is where also the chords are going to be played in a variation. We begin by sliding the D5 and E5 up 3 times. And then the fourth time, rather than again playing the D5 and E5, we are going to be playing a D5/A followed by an E5/B. And all we need to do for this, we're still in the same position, we add in our index finger to play the string below. So for the D5/A, we are now playing the 5th fret on the E, the 5th fret on the A, and the 7th frets on the D and G. Which we are sliding up 2 frets to play the 7th frets on the E and A, and the 9th frets on the D and G. Now for the ornament at the end of the bar, the first guitar is going to be sliding the 7th fret of the low E string down to the 2nd. And the second guitar is going to be sliding the 9th fret of a G down to the 4th. And then the song fades out.